Hi, I'm Ryan. I work in the media industry, and I've lived in China for almost 4 years now. 2021 marks the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Communist Party of China. And during those 100 years, its members have grown from a few dozen to over 95 million strong. Living in China, some of my friends and colleagues are party members. Now you might be curious, what exactly are these people like? So to help you get a better understanding, I've invited other foreigners who also live in China to go and visit young party members through various careers in an attempt to paint a clearer picture by better getting to know their life and their work. We hope to discover who these people really are. And I personally hope that these experiences help foreigners in China and abroad better understand this country and its people.
I'm Kate from Belarus. Being a Tsinghua University student, I've lived in Beijing for 3 years.
I learned that since 2004, China's desertification and sandy area have been significantly reduced, and China has treated more than 10 million hectares of sand in recent 5 years. The United Nations has also given high recognition to China's ecological construction achievements, and I'm really curious how China has done it.
Today, I'll be heading to Yulin, which is located in Shanxi Province in western China. I am eager to discover this area and find out more about the industry our hero is engaged in. Welcome to join me on my adventure. After taking a 9-hour train from Beijing, I am finally here in Yulin. Here, I'm about to meet our main hero, Shi Jianyang. I can't wait to see him and find out more about sand control industry in this area. Hello. Oh, finally, I see him.
我正在起苗基地呢，你要不要下来看一看？
Yes, of course. Thank you so much.
哎，好。Wow,
I see really big tree over here.
对，现在我们来到的这是樟子松的苗圃基地。我们现在所看到的这个就是所谓的樟子松，很适宜栽种，而且在治沙的这个树种里边，它属于工薪树种。一年它的生长周期长，它可以活到150年到200年。Wow. 它的寿命比较长，但是它生长速度是比较慢一点的，它一年长这么一层。Would
you say it's really hard to plant a tree? Does it take a lot of effort to plant one tree?
这个活其实也是比较每天重复这样的，一棵一棵种，不是说一个人跟一个公司就可以把这个树苗能种好。我们要众人拾柴火焰高，每个人都参与。一个人可能平均就在15棵到20棵左右，一年可能长10公分左右，到20-30年以后，这个树比较绿意盎然。
And what would you say is the main challenge while growing these trees in such conditions?
这个地方比较苦，而且环境比较恶劣，太阳也比较日照比较长，一直就在户外。Being
here in the desert in afternoon actually made me realize how hard it must be to work in these conditions for the whole day. Not only it requires a strong spirit, also you need to be physically strong in order to be able to work in these conditions. I'm eager to find out why he's so passionate about this and why he's willing to work in these conditions for a long time. Because I don't think that every young man would be able to work in these conditions, considering that it's just him and nature. So let's see and find out.
你小时候也是在这里长大的？对，在我在这里长大。哦，爷爷好。你好。我们家小时候，我叫冯三，把我都管住了30多年了。 如果不用那个铡刀种，也不一定铡就把我埋了。为何治铡有这么大决心？这个铡对人类危害太大，把铡制度就把老百姓的秋耕都拔了。这连我孙子3代人治铡了，那个树给我看见，就像孙子跟儿一样，就是这样，有感情了。就看看我身上那棵树。
这个树你可以抱出来。It's this one, so tall。你们俩给我抱一下。哈哈哈！现在包不住吧？这是当时种下第一棵树，
这37年了。哇！84年到现在。
我今年才是25岁，他已经37年了，他的年龄要比我的大。哈哈哈！
应该。 看这个树上也有皱纹了，我脸上也有皱纹，树也老了，我也树大了，人老了啊。
十三岁成了技师的时候，我平时也回来参加到植树这种行列里面。我爷爷跟我父亲，这种一幕幕在沙漠里面的这种制沙场景，以及一户户群众愿意跟着，爷爷他们一起加入到制沙行列里面去干制沙这一件事情，他们的目标就是改变当地的这种环境。从小我是从沙区里面长大的，然后对这片土地也有很深的感情。
上面过去都是这样的荒沙。
Wow, so this place used to look like that just around 30-40 years ago, and now it's transformed.
过去都是这样的泥沙，没有水分，所以最困难的其实治沙，要征服沙子这种恶劣环境。
石建言 told me that desertification used to spread in northwest China, seriously threatening the people living here.
过去从1984年时候。爷爷一直跟父亲投入在治沙里边，现在的所承包的25万亩荒沙已经全部得到了有效治理。现在我们看到这片沙漠是现在我们治理区仅存的一片沙漠，然后呢，现在呢我们看到的就是绿意盎然，这种一片林海，在当时那种情形，这是一个很大的一个质的变化。
在我12岁的那年，我的父亲从银川调树苗的归途中。意外发生了车祸，不幸离世，因故殉职。我的爷爷强忍着巨大的悲痛，带着我将父亲运回来的树苗栽在了沙漠中。如今那片树林早已郁郁葱葱。
What do you personally feel when you are planting a tree? What are your emotions and feelings inside?
我心里感到非常自豪，然后能跟着爷爷带领更多群众参与到治沙这个行列里边。
During my communication with Shi Jianyan, I felt that his grandfather and father had a great influence on his life.
我的爷爷呢，在1984年的时候，响应了党的号召，带领着农民建立了治沙队伍。经过数十年的努力，才有了今天我们眼前看到这一片片生机盎然的领地。爷爷呢，始终是我的一个榜样，一个标杆。今年呢，我也在大学毕业后，成为了一名年轻的中国共产党员。我希望从爷爷的手里接过接力棒，将老一辈的治沙精神传承下去。
然后我们入党的初心就是多去服务大家，去帮助周边的沙区的群众。我们现在公司有党支部4名年轻共产党员，都是90后，大学毕业后回乡创业。生态环境治理上面，我们几个会达成很多的心灵上的一种共鸣。
所以呢，我们就赶时间抢时间，所以时间紧任务重，所以呢大家也就辛苦。
当在治沙的过程中，我也遇到了很多困难，
压力是有的，但是作为我来说，我爷爷给我起到的是一种模范带头作用。他曾经给我说过，这个一生不需要干多大事情，但是要干一件真正有意义的事情，这种压力反而能化成动力。我们现在不仅要治理沙子，而且还要利用好沙子。我们现在所看到的这个打坑机打坑呢，这个技术我们运用在了治沙里边。我们过去每个人工靠人工挖的话，一天挖不了多少坑。通过有机械化的一种转变，过去从粗犷治沙往科技治沙这种转变呢，一天可以大2000窝以上，树木的成活率也高了，治沙的效率也高了。我们的用工量很少，而且是一种高效的治沙。这个营养壳你看都降解了，环保，放在土里直接就跟着土壤降解了。我们这里边现在生态好起来，有野兔、野鸡，然后有好多的野生动物，可以在这个环境下，因为我们这里也成保护区了，不仅它们在这里我感觉能生存下来，而且动植物吧，成一种自然的这种和谐的情况。
石建言 is a new generation of sand fighters.Not only returned to his hometown himself, but also brought back a new science that differed from traditional methods.
这里呢，就是我们通过发展沙产业，我们现在讲究就是沙漠治理住了，环境治理好了，然后我们要当地群众可以发展这种农田了。我们县也是种植马铃薯的示范县，就像我们现在培育的这种马铃薯苗，它是无土栽培的， 而且它底下是这种有机质，然后它这里面都是无菌的，而且是非常优良的这种品种，
就是在沙子当中完全可以活下来，完全可以成活，
在我们这个现在这个环境下就是非常适宜当地种植。我们要把这个马铃薯这个原种苗培育出来，然后每年的时候是发放给
那大家是否愿意接受呢？
在周边的反响是很好的，
他认可这个，
对对对，所以我们现在就是讲究，就是沙子也治理住了，周边的群众这种收益也得到了一种可靠的这种保障。
After exploring the lab and listening to our main hero's introduction, I've realized that tree planting and agriculture in general have been evolving at a great speed. New innovations have contributed a lot to the tree planting industry.
作为新一代治沙人，我会利用科技的力量，把荒漠真理变为当地百姓赖以生存的绿洲。十年树木，百年树人。治沙呢，不仅需要树苗和技术，也更需要治沙的接班人。所以呢，我越做扎根在沙漠里面的一棵树，将治沙造林这件事情坚持下去。我的爷爷出生在沙漠中，我的父亲沉睡在沙漠，而我现在又回到了这片沙漠。我不仅要把治沙这根接力棒接好，而且我要把治沙造林这件事情坚持下去，传承下去。